Hello Dr. and parents, this is Vishnu Gan Singh. Welcome to Learning Admission Media. Today we're going to discuss about the NEET PG 23 latest update. Yes, some of the updates which has been made till now, we're going to discuss on that. What's the latest update on PG 23, as well as we will be discussing about the expected revised cutoff for PG 23, as well as we're going to give some answers on the questions which has been asked to us frequently, that if your OBC certificate has been expired, then what can be done? What are the documents required for the counseling, or the what are the documents required at the time of joining your suite? So these are questions or these details will be covered in this video. So if you are new on this channel and if you agar aapne channel ko abhi tak subscribe nahi kiya to subscribe karke rakh sakte hain. Saath hi mein hamara Telegram channel Admission Media as well as Instagram page Admission Media bhi follow karke rakhein, kyunki kuch aur information hogi, kuch aur updates hogi regarding your college, these details will be shared there also. ऑलरेडी हमने शेयर करना स्टार्ट कर दिया है, तो अगर आपने नहीं ज्वाइन किया है तो करके रख सकते हैं. आउट ऑफ 42 डीम्ड यूनिवर्सिटीज, 42-43 डीम्ड यूनिवर्सिटीज, 13 हैज ऑलरेडी रिलीज देयर फी स्ट्रक्चर. दोज फी स्ट्रक्चर, द लिंक ऑफ दोज पर्टिकुलर फी स्ट्रक्चर एंड द कॉलेजेस डिटेल हैज बीन शेयर्ड इन अवर टेलीग्राम चैनल एडमिशन मीडिया. तो अगर आपने ज्वाइन नहीं किया है तो यू कैन व्यू द फी स्ट्रक्चर फ्रॉम देयर इटसेल्फ, द लिंक इज देयर, सो यू कैन डाउनलोड इट. If I talk about the PG 23 counseling, the expected date is still 15th of July. Multiple of the people or multiple of the other counselors are saying differently that 15th July or anything is not confirmed. See, in the Supreme Court, it has been already stated by the NMC official or the NMC court, the advocates, they have already mentioned there that from the 15th of July, counseling can be there. But yes, the fact is that they haven't mentioned that the counseling information bulletin will be released there, or information published will be on 15th of July or before, or your round one will be starting from there, or round one itself will end at the 15th of July, or the joining will start from the 15th of July. This clarification has not been made, but as they have declared or as they have shown the INI seat matrix, I mean INI counseling schedule, maximum probable chances that this month and or first week of July, we can have our counseling schedule as well as the information bulletin, and all the rules and regulation will be there. Those people or the information regarding your MCC common counseling is 100%, not but 99%, it is almost confirmed that your NMC common counseling or MCC common counseling is not happening for PG 2023, neither it is happening for UG 2023 also. Maximum probability is this only. Now if I talk about the revised cutoff, see, the assumptions are only made till now that this much seat has been increased or the NMC website and everything. Every year we have seen whatever the seats get added in the first half of the counseling or the before the counseling is not the actual seats which are displayed in the seat matrix. So all those details, 1000, 2000, 3000, 5000 seats are added till now on NMC website, not gonna matter till they appear in the seat matrix. But I'm not saying that there won't be any seat increment in this PG 23. Of course, last year already 3,000 to 4,000 seat has been added. In this session again, seat matrix will be added there. Seats increment will be seen and their effect on the counseling will be also shown. But only on the private, or I mean only on the government colleges, not much effect will be shown on the private colleges, because we have already cleared that how much candidates are eligible and what are the ranks between them and who are actual in the fight that they will be taking the seat. And especially if you're going for a private colleges or a states like UP, Bihar, Andhra, Telangana, you have to be very, very careful regarding your seats, because on the lower ranks people can also get. Or even if I talk about the Pondicherry, last year on 170 also or 175 also people have got clinical seat, but in this session possibilities are very, very tough, because till now the fee structure has not been released. Last year fee structure is only there, that is 22.75 lakh. Latest fee structure and all the states progress about NMC bill. I am not saying NMC bill will be implemented or whether it won't be happening. It will totally, or it's totally a state matter. The progress and the things are already ongoing. We have shared multiple of the details on this video, I mean on this topic. So if you haven't watched it, do watch it, because till now there is no progress in it. If there will be any progress, we will be sharing that also. Now if I talk about the revised cutoff, if you having a score, it's not a sure shot, but mainly I'm saying this because if you have to prepare all documents, But if your score is around 180 or 200 or 170 to 200 or 190 to 200 in around that, you will be safe. I'm not saying you will be eligible, but if your rank or if your score is around this, then you can start making your document and you can start the process for your counseling, or you can plan your counseling as per that. You can prepare your budget and everything, because the documents required for the counseling cannot be made in just within one day. Below that is also possible, higher than that is also possible. I'm not guessing any score, I'm just giving a simply number that if your score is in around this, then you can be feel safe and you can prepare your document. Now if I talk about the list of document required for the counseling, see, at the time of counseling or the at the time of choice filling or at the time of registration of counseling, you won't be required any document till the document verification is offline. In offline document verification, you have to present with the multiple of the documents which will be published at the time of counseling in their information bulletin. Those details and those list of documents will be shared separately. If you going just for the All India counseling or states counseling, you will be required your documents like your NMC bill, final year degree certificate, your registration number. These will be more than enough. Even we have already uploaded a video, step to step registration for All India counseling. That video will be shared to you again in our all the platform after the counseling began or at the time of registration. If you wish to watch it, it's already present on our YouTube channel, you can do watch it. Now I am gonna talk about the required document at the time of joining. Before that, if your OBC NCL certificate has been expired, or can you change your category to general, or can you change your category to OBC itself? Now I'm gonna answer that part. If you have put anything wrong in your category and you want to change it, then yes, you can change it. But if it is like that, you want to change it from general to any other category, that is not gonna happen even in the counseling. But from any other category to general or upgraded version can be possible. Matlab, simply, if you have put ST, then you can change it to SC. If you have put OBC, you can change it to general. But from general to OBC or general to SC or general to ST is not possible. So that's not gonna happen. Till now it's not been happened. In some particular special cases, if NMC has allowed you, that's a different thing. That's not I'm discussing. I'm talking on the general behalf. If your OBC NCL certificate has been expired, then you have to perform or you have to do your counseling under the general only. Because if in the mop-up round or in the round 2, if you have got allotment under the OBC category, and at the time of joining, if you fail to prove or if you fail to give your OBC NCL certificate, your seats will be cancelled. As well as in some states, the counseling rule is totally different. You might get removed from the counseling itself, or even in the mop-up round, if you got a seat in All India and you fail to prove your, or if you fail to present your OBC NCL, you will be out from the all the states as well as All India counseling. So be careful regarding this, and if you haven't made your document, do prepare it, and if possible do renew it. Otherwise it's already eligibility date, there is no problem. Now if I talk about the documents required at the time of joining, PH certificate is only for if you applicable, I mean physically handicapped certificate is required only if it is applicable. Second, online provisional letter which will be issued by MCC itself. Caste certificate, that is OBC, SC, ST certificate, if it is required there, then only. PG 2023 admit card which you have been printed on it and taken to the admission center, you will be required that. NEET PG 23 result or letter issued by NB, that is your result which has been given by NB to you, you will be required that. Marksheet of MBBS examination, the MBBS degree. Internship certificate, permanent or provisional registration certificate by MCI, NMC or state medical counseling, if you have applied there, that will be required. Your birth certificate, your 10th and 12th marksheet. Photo identity proof, that is your Aadhaar card, PAN card and voter ID card or passport, that will be required as your domicile certificate. Transfer or migration certificate or conduct certificate. 10 passport size of photographs candidates will be required, which is same as your PG admit card. Photocopies of all the certificates, 2 sets self-attached, 1 photo, and this list is already in our Telegram channel, we will be sharing there, you can download it. But make sure if you have made your NRI document, make sure your relationship certificate is confirmed and it is correct. Because if any way your if you have made your NRI document or anything falsely found in that, you might be banned from the counseling itself, because as per the internal sources, NMC is conducting a survey throughout the colleges. The seat which has been allotted in last two academic sessions on the NRI seats, they are asking their documents and they are again going to do some inspection on that. If anything can be found at that, the college as well as the person will be found guilty in that, and there's some major restrictions can also be taken in that. So if you're going for NRI seat, make sure your all the documents and everything is clear out. Nothing is there to be made. It's all legal and everything. How to proceed for a document, or how to plan for a low budget management seat, or how to, after even eligibility, if you're planning your counseling, how to proceed for that. These all details will be shared to us, as well as you can avail in our paid counseling guidance, which on for that you can contact on our contact number 9545955519. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching this video.